Hello. Of course, I have another race review for you today. I am reviewing the Peachtree Road Race that I traveled to Atlanta, Georgia to do on 4th of July weekend. I know y'all, it's been a minute since 4th of July, but I'm still going to give you this review and we're still going to put it out there because this was one of the best races I have ever done. So I definitely have to share. So stay tuned. You don't want to miss this. Hey, and welcome to Temple Running with MJ Smith. I am MJ Smith. If this is your first time here, welcome. And if you are visiting again, welcome back. And hey, so today I'm going to give you a review of my experience of the Peachtree Road Race in Atlanta, Georgia. The Peachtree Road Race is like the country's largest 10K. And with COVID happening, they made some modifications for it this year, but it was still an amazing experience. And normally, I have heard of this race before, but normally I am in New Orleans at the Essence Music Festival, 4th of July weekend. But somebody did point out to me that the Peachtree Road Race is on 4th of July every year. And 4th of July doesn't always fall on the weekend. So there are instances where I can do both the road race and do my Essence Music Festival. So I'm going to definitely look into that in the future because I would like to do this on a year where it has its normal, festivities surrounding it. So just quickly going through my experience. First of all, shout out to Mizuno Running and to Fit with CJ. If you don't already follow him, go and check his page out. He has all kind of great fitness content out there. And so I follow him on Instagram, and he had a contest for entry into the Peachtree Road Race because I saw some people announcing that they were going to do it. And I was like, oh, that sounds fun. Let me go check it out. And I went to check it out and it was sold out. So I was like, okay, I guess it's not for me this year. But then I saw this contest on CJ's page. So I checked it out. I went on and did the criteria. You know, it was follow him, follow Mizuno Running, was already doing that anyway, and answer some questions for more entries. I did all that. Ended up coming out, being one of the winners, was super excited. I love going to Atlanta. It just worked out for me. I do go to Atlanta frequently anyway, so it was nice to be able to get a run there. So got the entry, was super excited, traveled down to Atlanta, got down there. Prior to getting there, I had to pick a time to visit the expo because it's so many people in this race. So first of all, it's so many people who wanted to do this race. They broke it up into 2 days. So from my understanding, it's normally like 60,000 people out there on the one day, on the 4th of July. But they broke it up. They did a race on the 3rd and they did a race on the 4th, which kudos to Atlanta Track Club and all of the sponsors for this because that is a lot of work to throw two races this big back-to-back days. That was a lot of volunteers that were needed, but it was actually pretty cool because then like volunteers could then run the race the other day that they don't volunteer. So that was kind of a perk to it, but that's still just a lot of work, a lot of setup, a lot of tear down. So appreciate the folks who made this happen for us because like I said, wonderful experience. So got there to my expo time that I had reserved. Walked in, I had to show them, they had two different lines. One you go in if you had your COVID vaccine card, the other one if you didn't have it. And so I went in the COVID vaccine line. I don't really know what was happening in the other line. I don't know if you had to get tested or if I don't really know what was happening in that line. But in my line, I was able to flow right through. And when I got to the front to get my bib, they put like a sticker on it to show that I had my card and that I was vaccinated. This is the sticker that they added to my bib because I showed them my card. So I walk in after I get my bib, and this is all that I got, seriously. But I thought it was kind of cool because on the back of the bib, they gave us a mask. As you can see, I didn't use it because I have my own mask. but gave us a Running City USA mask. So I thought that was kind of a nice little added thing to show how serious we are about COVID. Got my bib. This was all I got. So, you know, I'm used to going to an expo. I get a bib and a t-shirt. So I was like, this is it. She was like, yes. I said, okay. So I left that part of the expo and walked in. And right away, Mizuno had all of the race gear. They had tanks. They had tees. They had shorts. I mean, they had full outfits. It was some really nice stuff. It was a little pricey. I think a tank was running about $32. So, you know, I didn't have a race shirt and I didn't know I was getting one, which you do. The Peachtree Road Race gives the shirt at the end of the race, which I was not aware of. So I didn't even think I was going to get a shirt. But I'm still glad that I found this beauty on the sale rack. It was $15, and this is what I used to run in. Because, you know, if they issued me a shirt, my tradition is that I will not wear it until I complete the race anyway. So I would have ran in my own gear. But I bought this tank, and since I bought it, I ran in it. And it was actually really cool to run in it. And now I have a nice, you know, shirt that I will wear, you know, just in training, that is commemorative of the road race. So I'm happy to have it. So walk through the rest of the expo after you get out of the Mizuno area. Atlanta Track Club had a lot of stuff set up. They also had like some games and stuff. There was just a very few booths, but I understand it wasn't the full out normal expo because this is not the full out normal race. So went in and then actually, rewind, at the expo, I ran into CJ, who I won the entry through, at the Mizuno booth. So he and I chatted. He kind of gave me some pointers, said it was probably a good idea for me to get a MARTA card so that I could, you know, park at a MARTA station and take the MARTA in, because everything with parking and everything was going to be really, really congested the next morning, really difficult with all the street, you know, closings and stuff like that. So I went on, took that advice, went around. On the way out, hit the MARTA, got my ticket, and left. So that was the expo. And then we got to the race morning. My husband decided just to take me to the race. So he dropped me off and kind of waited around for me to finish so that I didn't have to worry about parking. So shout out to the hubby for his support. That was really awesome. Because I told him I was going to be a while, because I had to chit chat with some of y'all, some of the people that I know, you know, with being a part of the IG running community. I know people that I don't even know. So I knew I was going to be chatting for a while. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Here I am once again, up before the sun to run a race. But I'm out here for the Peachtree Road Race 2021. Super excited. And the wheelchair athletes are already going. I don't know if you can see, but already going. My wave, I'm in wave C. And we start at 6:50, so it's a little after 6. It's 6:09 right now, and I'm making my way to the start line. Super excited. Anyway, got to the start line, was ready to go. Plenty of space, like had us very much spaced out. You could find your own space. It wasn't bunched up like I'm sure it usually is. I heard that it's really, really usually so packed that you can, you know, hardly move and everything, but we were good. They had us spread out. The waves were split up and very distinct. And so I went up there. I was in wave C. I got up there pretty quickly and we headed out. I can't tell you. It was such a good course. Like, it was a lot of downhill. So y'all know I was happy about that because I don't like hills. So, I mean, I had some splits that were under 8 minutes. Like, I had some splits that were like 7:20 something. Like, I was pushing, and I don't know why I was running so fast. I don't know if it was the adrenaline, if it was the fact that we were going downhill, if it was just like I knew I only had to run 10K. But even having to run 10K, I still usually take my time. But my body was saying, I can do this today. So I ended up finishing the race. And on the course, I got to see my favorite mayor, Keisha Lance Bottoms. Fellow Rattler from FAMU, so got to give her a wave and everything, so that was pretty exciting. And just the support, you know, even though they weren't really letting a lot of people come out to cheer us on, there were people still there, and it was amazing. They had bottles of water for us at the water stops. Everything was very well put together. Like I said, I had space. At no point did I feel congested and packed in with anybody else. So it was awesome. So I finally got to like mile 4.5, 5, and I started getting a little like, okay, you started off way too fast. I started getting that feeling. You know, I started mentally telling myself like you were going too fast. So I finally slowed down a little bit. And then I realized it was because I was on cardiac heel. I had started going straight uphill for a long time. So made it through that, got to the finish line. So I made it to the finish. Y'all see all of this? This is crazy, right? This is that Georgia heat right here that'll have you going. But so I just had to go and buy a medal. I didn't know I didn't get a medal with this, y'all. Y'all know I don't do races if I don't get a medal. So I had to go and purchase one, a commemorative medal, finisher medal, because this is a big race and I do want to, you know, have something to show for it. But I ran crazy, y'all. Ooh, I like that sunlight. I'm gonna go back in the sun. But I ran so crazy fast. I am so proud of myself. I didn't even think I could run that fast, as fast as I ran. So it was actually really, really a great race. And the course was pretty good. It had a few hills that tripped me up a little bit. Y'all know how I do not like hills. But it was still like an incredible race. And I'm super excited and super glad that I traveled down here to do it. Y'all know I love ATL. So it was nice that this 4th of July, I got to do this race. So out here, but Peachtree Road Race, phenomenal race. People all along the course. I probably should have got some course footage, but I didn't do that, y'all. I was too into the run. It was a lot of downhill, which really helped. And I just really enjoyed it, but I really enjoyed this race. It is as great as everybody said it is, even though this is a different year, split into 2 days, and you know, half the amount of people that normally get to run it. I ran into my favorite mayor, even though I'm not from Atlanta, Keisha Lance Bottoms, my fellow Rattler. It was good to see her on the course. It was just a phenomenal race. And so you could tell by this smile that it was really good. So, anyway, I'm going to get somewhere where I can get this sweat out of my eyes and get y'all back to the show. It was wonderful. Met up with some folks, saw some folks out there, took some pictures, even got to be on the news. I was on Channel 11 News.
Come on. Didn't have to dodge anybody. No yeah. Weaving this year.
Yeah.
This is my first one, so.
First timer. You know, all these first timers are sneaking in here. Mm-hmm. You know, how did you get in?
I won the Mizuno contest with the Fit CJ page. So it was great.
You think you come back?
I would definitely come back.
If she can get in.
If
we'll let her in. I don't know.
We gotta let her in. Look, by the way.
There. So it was just phenomenal. So after I finished, I just walked to the main street. My husband met me and I was pretty much done. But I was still so like high off the adrenaline of the race for so long after. Oh, so after I did finish, though, I did go to the tent because when I finished, I got a T-shirt. I got a applesauce and a nutrition bar wrapped in a T-shirt. That was the finishing package. And so I was looking at it and I'm like, where's my medal? There is no medal for Peachtree Road Race, not one that comes with your entry and registration, but they do have commemorative medals available. And so I bought one. So you know I had to get me some bling. I am not running a race, especially one as great as this one, that I really know that I'm going to want to remember this year that I ran this race. So this is the medal. Well, let me move my hand. This is the medal. And on the back, it just says Atlanta Track Club. I was about to say, I'm looking at it and I don't see where it says 2021, but right there it says 2021, Atlanta, Georgia. So got my commemorative medal. And so once again, I just want to thank Mizuno Running, Fit with CJ, and the city of Atlanta for a wonderful experience. I will be back for a road race again. This was only my second 10K that I've ever done. I usually don't want to travel and I don't want to even like use the resources to do a 10K, but this one is worth it. So to all you marathoners and half marathoners that think a 10K might not be worth it, this might be one you want to try. I definitely enjoyed it and I would do it again in a heartbeat. I plan to do it again. So yes, that's my review of the Peachtree Road Race. So that's all I have for you today. If you have not already, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to know when I upload new videos, don't forget to hit that bell. I try to upload once a week or so. So please hit the bell so that you know when I put up new videos. And also, if you aren't already, please check me out on social media where I do my runner blog. I am on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And Instagram is the main hub. So if you're on IG, find me there. And just follow my run journey if you'd like. And I also like to follow some of your run journey. So I appreciate that support. And until next time, are you in?